All right, guys, a nice and easy one today. This is a deep relaxation, deep recovery, nice and slow flow. So I'm using this today. It's the Friday for me. I've had a really big week, surfed a lot, ran a lot, did a couple of power hours. So the body's sore, a little bit tighter than usual, a lot of sitting down, big work week. So I just want to feel really good. So tomorrow's Saturday, I'm just loose, recovered, recharged, and ready to go. Remember, we grow in the yin, in the recovery, in the light stuff, not constant crash and bash. So to start with today, you can do this lying down or sitting up. We're just going to do, often this is used as a meditation, but today, because we want to just connect with the body, I'm doing this before the workout. Normally we'd do this after, but I want you to connect the body, mind, breath with the different muscle groups. So to start with, we're just going to find a nice, open, relaxed position, smooth breathing in and out of the nose. Mindful breathing. Blissful breathing. Just into the belly. Raising awareness. And now just directing your energy into the feet. So I want you to take a deep breath in, bring that chi into the feet, and relax the feet on the exhale. Breathing into the calves. Feel the calves release on the exhale. Breathing in and around the knees. And release. Breathing into the hamstrings and quads, that whole region. And release it. Breathing into the groin region, all the muscles around there. Release it. Breathing into the stomach and lower back. Breathing all the way into the spine and feel the spine release. Breathing into the rib cage. Feel that release. Breathing into the shoulders, traps. Relax. And breathing into the jaw, neck. Release. And breathing into the temple, crown of the head. And just one breath into the whole body. And relax. Starting with the neck. Nice, slow, large circles. Smooth, soothing breath. Same with the shoulders. Circles both directions. And just opening up the side body. Focus on that side body. Breathe into the open space. We'll hold a little longer in some of the yoga poses today. Animal movement's going to be slow-mo and easy. Any Pilates we do will be not a lot of stabilization either. So just really get to relax. Tilting back, facing the hands backwards, driving the hips up. Let the head go. Pushing those hips high. I'm just kind of pressing up around the chest, opening up the shoulder as well. And floating forward.
Resting the head on the floor if you can.
And floating up. Nice and wide.
Just crawling the hands forward as far as they can.
Coming back up. And back up. One more. A little deeper each time, I hope. We can still push the stretch a little today. And floating the feet together, very slowly crawling our way forward. Knees bent at the start, just so you're hinging at the hips. And bring the head down. And as you loosen up, you can straighten the legs. Just release the hamstrings, lower back. You want to combine the toes facing forward and up. Clench. And slowly floating back up. Crossing the legs, rolling forward. We will do some light circles of the wrist, both directions. Same thing with the shoulders, keeping the arms straight. And I love a cat-cow dance, especially on a recovery session, just finding fluidity, twisting, turning, all different shapes. Exaggerate the bends and twists in the back as much as you can. Neck's going as well. And just adjusting so your hips are above the knees. We're gonna float forward onto the fingertips, looking forward into a puppy pose. You can rest the head if you like. I like to extend the stretch, pushing the arms, armpits down, looking up. And sitting into child pose. Deep, slow breaths. Crawling over the hands to the left and stacked. Scooping the floor forward, coming up. You can keep the hips down for now. Opening up, not too heavy on the wrists. You can rotate the neck a little if you like. And melting the hips back and up into our first down dog. Walking it out. Slow. Smooth. We will glide that left foot up nice and tall for a reach, and we'll float it outside the left hand, dropping the back knee, bringing the chest up. You can drop down onto the forearms if you want to extend the stretch. And relax. Relax. And from here, we're gonna raise the left hand up to the sky, below the lower back, twist it open. And floating back, coming back up, floating into down dog. Right foot glides as high as we can, floats gently, softly outside. Right hand, we drop the back foot, floating down if we can. Relax the breath. Inner part of the thigh, hip flexor, great stretching in the leg. Floating that right hand high behind the lower back. Slowly rotate, open the shoulder. Even deeper hip flexor stretch as well. And floating back down. Gliding back to down dog. Floating the left foot up high this time. Gliding the left knee forward towards the left hand. Opening up a nice proud pigeon. Hips aligned and parallel. Chest proud. If you can, bring that right foot all the way up, grabbing it with the left hand and touching the glute if you can. Loosen up the glutes as well. Keep that head up. Oh, great stretch of the quad. And release. Floating back, melting into down dog. The right leg melts high to the sky, floats towards the right hand. We open the chest, hips parallel and level. We open up. Deep breathing, smooth and slow. Raising that left foot, holding it with the right hand and bringing it all the way into the glute if you can. Release. Just floating that foot back down now. Just get a little bit of a thoracic twist and open up that upper body section a little. I'm going to slide the right hand all the way through, resting my head on the floor. Nice easy one today. Hand reaching forward. Deep breaths nice and wide. And floating your way out and switch. All the way through, rest the head, rest the shoulder. Right hand crawls forward, three breaths. And floating back up and out. As we come up, one modification here. If you have lower back issues, just hold it and lean back. If you can, you can go one hand or you can go two. All the way up. Relax. And floating your way back up. Sitting up or sitting back down, bringing the legs forward. We're just gonna do some internal rotation, focus work around the hips. Really pressing it into the floor. This will sort your tight hips out. Nice and easy. Let's work the mobility of these joints. Beautiful. From here, we're going to come into a rotating pigeon. It's quite similar in nature. I want this foot resting in here. We drive the hips up. So I wouldn't sit like this on the mat normally. I'm just doing it for you guys. So I internally rotate sit and drive up. Little activation here through the core, but I'm working that internal rotation, coming up, strengthen, activate, gentle. The tighter the little internal rotation goes, the better. And floating it up. And that should feel nice on the hips. A little bit of a challenging one for the hips. We're gonna go nice and wide. So see, my knees are very lateral. They're not back here. Think a straight line. And then think about getting this at 90 degrees, if you can, into this frog stretch. And you can rock forward and back. Widen the legs if you can. Release this whole region. Both sides of the hips, hip flexors, and some of the previous ones. And bring the feet together, crawling back, and we'll float up to our feet. We're gonna do a wider ape squat today, a little bit easier. And just rock left to right, trying to keep the feet flat. And just float left to right. It's a little bit, I like this little bit wider, different sensation. Open up the chest a little if you can. We will come up for just one and slow-mo down. A little activation of the muscle, important. Little external rotations if you can. And then grabbing around one ankle, rotating up, switching. Trying to keep both feet down. And we want that arm going all the way to the sky. If you're tight, it might get stuck there and the feet will come up. I'm gonna get them both flat all the way up. Improve the rotation. If you really wanna challenge the shoulders, you can do the chicken, I think wing it's called, which I think that's the correct term. And bring the knees in, get those shoulders. Oh, great one. Relax is the most important thing. And just have a little play around. Nice and easy. And relax. Dropping to the knees, shaking it all out. Just get nice and loose. Winding through the spine. For this one, just some more spinal work. Hands here. We come around deep circles. All the way up. Both directions. Just get that spine twisting and turning. Oh, feels great. And one more. And for this one, I want you to create a big W, chest up to the sky. Reach forward, link the fingers together, push away. Pull back the shoulders, chest to the sky. Deep breath in. And relax. We've done a pretty good scan of the whole body now. We're gonna do a nice and easy animal movement here. So we're gonna do the duck walk, but in slow motion. Just sit here, relax, float around, and then move forward like we would. So normally with a duck walk, it's a bit quicker. This one, I'm just kind of rotating. And trying to keep that foot flat. And see, I'm just getting that circular movement. No real rules. Circling. Trying to keep that foot flat. Deep circles with that knee. both directions. And relax. Feet come nice and wide. We're just gonna go into a nice Spider-Man. So Spider-Man, I come through Cossack. See how my hand comes behind? So I create a nice lateral movement. And then nice and gently floating to the other side. Slow motion, find that finesse, find that style. Use your hands the whole way across. Open up. Trying to keep this foot flat. And relax. Nice and easy today. We're gonna do a side kick through, a bit of a wild thing formation to finish our animal flow, but it's gonna be nice and easy. So all I'm doing, I'm not even gonna come into my float for long. We're not looking for activation today. I'm gonna float the left foot out, drop it, glide up. Floating back down through my load or my hovering beast. Lean on the right, kick with the right, drop the foot, press high. And then we just float like a dancer, left to right, opening up the shoulder, the lower back, the hips. Soft, long, bendy. Play with it, slow it down. Feel, see, I'm almost making, almost like a ribbon in my hand, like you've seen people twirl those ribbons. And relax, coming back forward. Onto the knees, loosen up. Wherever you need to. We're gonna come into a very nice and easy Pilates flow now. Loosen it up. First one, nice and easy. Almost like we're gonna do a knee push-up, but we're just gonna float. Open. And open. Twist. Working laterally with that arm as far past center as I can. A recovery session today. This feels great. This feels good. Overworking the upper body. And floating forward into a lower dog. Floating back down, hands at around eye level, opening up the back. We're gonna come into this nice, easy swan, almost like a rocking boat. So press up, nice straight arms. Opening up, little bit of activation through the glutes, hamstrings, that's okay. Couple more. And floating back for a quick child pose. Hips sink as deep as they can. I reach forward. Release the breath. Make a noise. And floating up to tabletop. We're going to work our hip circles here. So keeping the core is active here. To keep that right hip still, but the left one does the deep circles. Five one way, five the other. Nice and easy. The larger the range of motion, the better. Switching sides when you're there. Now I'm active through the left hip so it does not move. High, large as I can. Changing directions once you're at five. And relax. The left foot goes wide. nice and lateral. And this is quite a difficult exercise. If we do a lot of reps, we're not gonna do a lot of reps. You're just gonna have a little stretch, come back down, float up, get it high. So there's a little bit of work here. You may even get a little cramp there, which is fine. Open up, sink back, float up, open high. Open up those really tight spots in those outer glutes and hips. And other side, same thing, nice and wide. Sit back, get that stretch, float forward, raise it high. All the way back, my bum hits my foot. Great stretch, nice opener. And relax, knees come back, body comes down. Quick Pilates breath, nice and wide, head rests on the hands, deep breath wide through the rib cage. And extending that right hand long, we come onto our side body. And we're just gonna open up high as we can. Float back down, just for 10. Foot clenched, point the toe on the way down. Open higher and higher with each one. And switching sides. Opening up, keep that leg dead straight. Put it 90 degrees for a deep stretch. And relax. Coming back up, bringing the knees forward, crossing the legs, floating back down. Reverse tabletop. We're gonna just make it nice and smooth and easy so we don't need a lot of contraction. Just leaning on the left, open that right hand towards the left hand. You can even take a seat today between. And just open up and alternate. Couple more. Not too worried about form today, just so relaxing, nice and easy. And facing both hands back. And just lean, coming forward, stretching out the anterior part of the shoulder. And a couple of balls up to balance, rolling back and up. And on that last one back, I'll just adjust myself so you can see a little better. Actually, I might not. You'll just have to watch. Coming all the way back over, trying to get the feet flat, legs straight, if you can. If you get stuck up here and need to hold yourself, that's fine too. Relaxing back, hands nice and wide, all the way to one side. So I bring my left hand on the knees, I lock my right shoulder on the floor, look at my right hand, and get that side body twist. You can rotate between the left to right as fast or slow as you need. Try and control the movement across, get a little bit of core in. Deep breath. And release. Coming back up. crossing the legs, coming forward and stepping back into down dog, walking that back out. Floating that left foot nice and high. We're gonna float that knee forward through center. Open up the pigeon once again, but this is almost gonna be part of our meditation. Lying forward, we're gonna do 3 minutes of rest either side. So this is almost like a yin yoga pose, my favorite. And I just want you to go into a place of no mind, nothingness. Smooth breathing. Empty your mind. Any thoughts that come in, just return to blank space. Tap into the universal mind, the spirit world. Another minute or so. Keep bringing the mind to nothing. Slowly floating up, you can switch the knees. Open up first, lie long.
Same thing. on the home stretch.
Slowly floating your way back up, sliding those legs back in, bringing the feet together, just having a little rock around. Remember, today's just about getting loose, free. So any last little spots, I'm still feeling a little tightness around the groins, so I'm just gonna have a little play, last minute loosen up. I can loosen my body just by being loose. Loosen up the muscles, loosen the mind. Smile, shake, roll, whatever you need to do. Lift upper body still, whatever you need to do. Shoulder joint, yeah. Neck, everything's good. I'm nice and relaxed, I'm nice and loose. Have a great evening or rest of your day.